Scream was an incredibly famous movie among teenagers in the late 1990s. Its success paved way for multiple sequels that came out shortly after the first. However, the Scream franchise also inspired various crimes. Number 1. Gina Castile. Gina was born in 1961. She was an incredibly loving mother who always looked after her teenage son and her one-year-old daughter. However, she was worried about the influence her troubled nephew, Samuel Jeremias Ramirez, age 16, who used to do a lot of drugs, would have on her son, Mario Salvador Padilla, age 17, as they both were very close. Both the boys were obsessed with Scream and its sequel, Scream 2. They planned to kill both the parents and soon go on a killing spree. Gina was discovered in her apartment on January 13, 1998, after calling 911 and telling an emergency operator that her son had stabbed her. It is believed that Samuel's older brother also took part in planning the killing but wasn't involved in the actual murder. The mother was murdered brutally by getting stabbed 45 times with 4 knives and a screwdriver. She managed to also call her husband before she died. All 3 boys were arrested. Samuel held Gina down while her son, Mario, did the stabbing. Although I couldn't find information on the sentencing Samuel's older brother received, Samuel himself faced a sentence of 25 years to life, whereas Mario was sentenced to life in prison without parole. The boys wanted to copy the costumes of the Ghostface killer in the movies to do their killings, but they couldn't afford to do so. They also had a plan to kill more people in the same manner as was shown in both the movies. Number 2. Ashley Murray. Ashley was only 13 years old when his best friend Daniel Gill, age 14, partnered with another student named Robert Fuller, age 15, to murder Ashley. Daniel and Robert, also known as the Scream Attackers, had watched Scream and were heavily inspired by the movie to plan a method to kill Ashley. Ashley trusted Daniel a lot, and would spend a lot of time with him, as he was his best friend. One day, after a football match, the 3 boys headed up to a nearby birdwatching hut. They started walking down the steep crag. After 5 minutes, Daniel and Robert attacked him from behind. One of them stabbed him in the cheek and it went straight through and knocked out his teeth. He tried to run but he fell over. The 2 boys stabbed him with a screwdriver and a knife for nearly 30 minutes before they thought that he had finally died. They wrapped him in a bin bag and ran away. It was not until more than 40 hours after the attack that he was discovered by an elderly man walking his dog. When paramedics arrived, he was rushed to hospital, where he spent 7 months undergoing operations. He was so heartbroken over what his best friend had done that he lost faith in human beings. He wouldn't even trust his family. But his misery didn't finish there. The 2 boys were only given a minimum 6-year sentence. They were released after 3 years, and moved back home close to Ashley. At this point, Ashley was too scared to go out fearing that the boys would attack him again. He argued that they weren't given an appropriate sentence. He believed that Robert Fuller hadn't changed at all as he was still very aggressive. Unfortunately, Ashley passed away in 2012 in a car crash at the age of 27. Number 3. Cassie Jo Stoddard. Brian Lee Draper and Tori Michael Adamczyk were 2 high school students at Pocatello High School in Idaho. They were both interested in films and started recording their own. They were also good friends with Cassie Jo Stoddard, another student. They also became friends with Cassie's boyfriend, Matt Beckham. One weekend, Cassie had agreed to house sit for her uncle, Frank Contreras, and his wife, Allison. That night, she invited Matt over, who also invited Brian and Tori to come over to watch a movie. But they both denied and said they were going to a movie theater instead. 15 minutes later, the power at the residence went out while Cassie and Matt were watching a movie. It was restored before Matt was picked up by his mother. After Brian and Tori learned that Matt had left, they went to her home. Brian cut the lights at the circuit breaker, making the house inside pitch black. They went upstairs disguised with masks and dark clothing and stabbed Cassie to death 30 times. 12 wounds were potentially fatal. 3 days later, they were arrested and charged with the murder. In their interrogations, both blamed each other, but it was later found that they had recorded a video talking about murdering Cassie before and after the attack.
There should be no law against killing people. I know it's a wrong thing, but hell, you restrict somebody from it, they're gonna want it more.
We found our victim, and sad as it may be, she's our friend. But you know what? We all have to make sacrifices. Our first victim is going to be Cassie Stoddard. She's going to be alone in a big, dark house out in the middle of nowhere. How perfect can you get? I mean, like, holy shit, dude.
I'm horny just thinking about it.
Hell yeah. It was 9:50, September 22nd, 2006. We know there's lots of doors. There's lots of places to hide. I locked the back doors. It's all locked. Now we just gotta wait.
I just killed Cassie. We just left her house. This is not a fucking joke.
I'm shaking.
I stabbed her in the throat and I saw her lifeless body just disappear. Dude, I just killed Cassie. Oh, fuck. That felt like fucking real. I mean, it went by so fast.
Shut the fuck up. We gotta get our act straight.
Okay.
They claimed that they were inspired by the Scream franchise and the Columbine High School shooters to commit the murder. Each received a mandatory sentence of life in prison without the possibility for parole, and 30 years to life for being convicted of conspiracy to commit murder. Number 4, Allison Cambier. Allison was a 15-year-old girl who lived in the small Belgian town of Gerpins. Thierry Gerardin, a 24-year-old man, lived a nearby. He was absolutely obsessed with Allison and wanted to be with her. He was a lonely truck driver and would find ways to approach her. He came to her home to exchange videotapes and have a conversation. He then made sexual advances on her, but she turned him down, which really upset him. He excused himself from the room and returned with wearing the Scream mask and had two enormous knives. He stabbed her 30 times and laid the body on his bed, put a rose in one of her hands and called a colleague and his father with a confession. He received a sentence of life in prison with no possibility of parole. Gerardin confessed that the killing was premeditated and influenced by the Scream movie. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video.